When you feel love for yourself or for another, you are a perfect vibrational match to the source within you. When you feel hatred or anger toward someone else or toward yourself, you are nowhere near the vibrational equivalent of your source. And that vibrational variance between who you're letting yourself be and who you really are is noted to you by your negative emotion. Negative emotion, whatever degree of it you're experiencing, always means to that degree you're pinching yourself off from the fullness of who you are. When you allow yourself in your physical human form to ride the rocket of desire that the source within you is riding, you feel passion, you feel enthusiasm, you feel love, you feel certainty, you feel flexibility and vitality, you are energized, you are in love with life. That is who you really are. And when you feel frustration, when you feel overwhelmment, when you feel anger or greater anger, when you feel rage or disappointment, when you feel fear or depression, you are pinching yourself off incrementally more and more and more and more and more from who you really are. And so we want you to understand that the emotions that you feel are in every moment that you are feeling them, whether they feel like love or whether they feel like despair. The emotion that you are feeling is always, every single time, your indicator of your vibrational relationship between who life has caused you to become and who you're letting yourself be right here in this moment by virtue of whatever it is you're giving your attention to. Talk about moment by moment, segment by segment guidance. Talk about always having a bead on who you really are and what you really want and where you said you really want to go. In other words, this is sophisticated guidance that is with you always once you learn to read it. Your navigational systems in your vehicles are similar. They know where you are. They know where you are. And you program in your desired destination, and the system calculates the route between where you are and where you want to be. And your guidance system is the same way. Here you stand, maybe with not enough money, or with a relationship that feels awful, or with a bodily condition that isn't pleasing you or is frightening you. Here you stand in that contrasting experience, sending out rockets of desires constantly for an improved experience. More rockets now than ever before, because knowing what you don't want helps you to identify what you do want. And the source within you not only rides those rockets, but becomes the vibrational equivalent of the new and expanded you. So the question that we want to put to you, and really what the Art of Allowing workshop is asking of you, are you right now, by virtue of what you're thinking and speaking, are you letting yourself keep up with you? Are you keeping up with who life has caused you to become? And if you are, we'll go right back to the first thing that we said to you this morning. If you are, then you're tuned in, tapped in, turned on. You feel great. If you are, then you are a vibrational extension. You are allowing yourself to be that extended version of you. Then you are seeing the world through the eyes of Source. And if you are feeling negative emotion, then it means that something has your attention, and it is certainly valid. In other words, we know you don't make this stuff up. You're not making it up. You are observing it. You're not deliberately trying to hold yourself apart from who you are. But anytime you feel negative emotion, you are nevertheless doing exactly that. You're holding yourself apart from who you are. So what we're suggesting is that rather than letting an unwanted event train your vortex, train your vibration away from the vortex, train your vibration into compliance with unwanted things, where you just sort of go along with it because it's happening, we want you to be aware that you have the power of focus. And we want you to be aware that when you know what you don't want a little bit, you put its equivalent in your vortex. So when you sort of don't want something, you sort of want something, and that sort of wanted thing goes into your vortex. It's equivalent. It's the specifics of what you do want are equivalent to the specifics of what you don't want, and other way around. So by the time you've built something into this pathway of what you really don't want, you have, without knowing it, constructed a really specific what you do want over here in your vortex of creation. We call this vortex of creation. It's the bounce and the holding place where the evolved version of you is held in vibrational readiness for your attention to it. It's there. Now, If you're talking about manifestations, then you're probably not all that interested in these vibrational thought ways that have been carved out. But we want you to understand that the vibrational thought way that you've carved out is going to manifest depending upon where you eventually light in terms of your vibrational readiness. So we want to say to you, you can let unwanted things train your vibration into a match with what you don't want, and law of attraction will show you the evidence of where you are. Or you can let the vortex, which is the holding place for all things wanted, train you into a vibrational frequency, and the manifestation of those wanted things will show themselves to you. But what we really want, what we really, 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 really want, what we want more than all other things put together, what we want, Jerry's always saying, Abraham, what do you want? What we want, 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 is that you will accept the construction of these thought ways prior to their manifestation. Because if you will accept the thought ways of these creations, if you will accept the creation of your vortex, if you will accept the creation of the unwanted things, if you will accept that they are being created by your attention and therefore by your creation of thought ways, if you will accept that they are being created long before they manifest, and you will pay attention to how you feel during the creation process, not only two things will happen. Two really good things. One, so much better than the other, but we're in disagreement with you about which one is the better thing. Two things will happen. One thing is sure, the manifestation of what you're focusing upon the most will happen. It will happen. It's law. It will happen. It's a done deal. It's a sure thing. It will happen. You will get what you are vibrationally active about. Better said, you're getting what you are vibrationally active about. So one thing, it will manifest. But the other thing is, and this is our favorite part of all of this, is that when you accept that this vortex is spinning and that this vortex contains the I know what I do want part of everything that you've been living, when you accept that and you let that vortex train you into vibrational compliance or alignment, then every step of your journey, even before the manifestation begins to reveal itself to you, is fun. It's pleasurable. You're frisky, you're full, you're inspired, you're enlightened. You feel that energy, you feel that enthusiasm, you feel that passion. You feel what a creator feels when you're moving in the direction of who you really are. So we want to remind you that the emotions that you feel are nothing more than, and oh, is it ever important what they are. They are nothing more than your indicator about whether you're moving down a thought pathway towards something unwanted or whether you're moving down a thought pathway towards something that you are wanting. In other words, every time you feel negative emotion, it always means the same thing. You're moving toward unwanted and away from wanted. Every time you feel positive emotion, it means you're moving toward wanted and away from unwanted. In other words, you're the focuser of all of that, period. There is no getting around it. So when you use excuses like it's interesting, or it's happening, it's a world event, and it's happening, and I don't want to be unaware, when you use excuses like, well, I need to be informed, when you use excuses like, well, it's true, when you use excuses like, well, I need to explain it to someone, or they don't get me unless I really get involved, or I won't be taken seriously unless I have a really objective viewpoint about things. There are all kinds of such flawed reasoning, bogus reasons that you use for your explanation of why you focus away from who you are, that we come and get a little rowdy in our explanation that you are the creator of your experience and you are building constant thought ways. And you have come with the intention of selecting and joyfully moving down those pathways for the constant, never-ending, extraordinary discovery of what this magnificent universe can dish out to you as a representation of what you've got going on vibration.